The Vatican Summit on Abuse ended Sunday. Church leaders still have a lot of work to do. Father Hans Zollner admits it. He was one of the summit's organizers, and he's a member of the Vatican Commission for the Protection of Minors. Father Zollner briefs our Rome Bureau Chief Alan Holdren on the next steps needed to tackle this issue plaguing the church.
How did the meeting impact you personally?
It had a huge impact on me because I saw people from all over the world. I saw the church leaders here, and in a spirit of prayer, in a spirit of renewal, in a spirit of listening, and in a spirit of taking on this very difficult issue for the church.
So the Pope has asked repeatedly for no effort to be spared in addressing this scourge in the church. Can you honestly say that no effort is being spared?
I cannot say that for every diocese and for every religious congregations. I think this meeting has shown that the Pope has not spared any effort in bringing here to Rome the church leaders in a way that never happened before.
What's stopping the Vatican from implementing measures for bishops holding each other accountable?
The law that the Holy Father, Pope Francis, issued in September 2016 as a loving mother is that law. What we need is a clarity about how those this law is applied according to the different dicasteries that are co-responsible in dealing with the issue.
What do you personally think should happen to bishops who cover up the abuses of others?
If it is a severe case of cover-up, the bishop can be dismissed from his office, can be removed from any kind of pastoral activity, or can be dismissed from the clerical state. And we have had such cases.
The follow-up to this meeting has already taken place. A first meeting took place just yesterday between the heads of different departments of the Holy See and also the organizing committee of the meeting. What did you decide will happen insofar as these task forces that have been spoken about?
We will now start to look for people who can be employed in that, and then we will need to coordinate their activities, identifying, I would say, according to a list of criteria. One criterion could be that this bishop's conference has not yet developed a full-scale guideline, so we go there and help them to flesh that out. Another criterion could be that this church is in a state of denial, and we want them to start discussing this publicly.
So would you say that this meeting was a success?
I would say it was a success, at least in that sense, that when people went away, they were telling me and they were showing that that they have understood, but not only in the mind, not only because they got some information, but by the heart, that they know now that they have been transformed. A number of those who were hesitant at the beginning, they clearly spoke about the necessity to work with their bishop brother bishops at home, the bishops' conference or the religious, and bring this to the ground. Because the church, yes, is one, and Rome is important, but the concrete work has also to be done on the ground.
Father Hans Zollner, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.